không in achieving success. One needs to be proactive, focused, and persistent in pursuit of their goals, as success does not come to those who are idle or passive. There is no replacement for hard work. The great scholar Panini also stressed upon the same. As the astrology forecast, Panini lacked education in his destiny. But with his diligence, hard work, and strong determination, he became a great Sanskrit scholar. Now, we are going to present before you the importance of right action and hard work at the right time through the story of the ant and the grasshopper.
Let's go there.
Today will not last for long. So start collecting from today. Well, we have plenty of fruits and leaves and winters are so far. Time is of essence. Soon there will be snow all around. So we must forage food.
There is still time for winters. Till then, let's play, dance and have fun.
Thank you.
you. My dear grasshopper, take this blanket. You will feel warm and cozy.
We have some hot soup.
Challenges!
Yoda studied without laziness. He recalls, but he learned his lesson before it was too late. You must not procrastinate. Rather, you should make preparations so that you would have no regrets. He now teaches.
The art of living for a student initiates by imbibing the first lesson, that is, putting in right efforts at the right action.
There is a problem. There is indeed a
solution. Once you have identified the problem, the solution will become evident if you truly seek it. Please share what troubles you.
I find it exceedingly challenging to maintain focus on any task. My thoughts quickly scatter.
Yes, ma'am. I do struggle with concentration and harbor a persistent fear of failure.
I seem unable to attain success in any endeavor. You are a river sage. We seek your guidance in resolving this issue.
I encourage each of you to contemplate on your problems and offer gratitude to the divine for presenting these challenges. Wherever your focus goes, there flows your energy. I shall assign a small task that will enable you to regain control of your mind.
What task do you have in mind, Martin?
It's a flower known as Nilambar, found on the top of a hill approximately 20 kilometers from here. Please fetch this flower for me.
How will we recognize this flower?
You shall identify the Nilambar by its unparalleled beauty. There is no flower as beautiful as the blue Nilambari. Blue Nilambari flowers are known for their distinctive blue color and unusual shape. They are tubular in form with a long slender tail. The flowers are arranged in clusters on tall spikes. The entire hill is adorned with these exquisite blossoms. I shall resolve your issues once you bring me this flower.
As you wish, Mahatma.
Bear in mind that the entire route passes through a dense forest. So, exercise caution and display bravery in safeguarding yourselves from potential perils.
Pranam, Mahatma. Bow and set forth carrying food and water. They embarked on the day with great enthusiasm. Yet, as evening descended, the path was engulfed in darkness. The first disciple became apprehensive, troubled by the sounds of wild animals emanating from the forest.
of the dark and the white creatures. Pressing on, along the way, they encountered a magnificent garden teeming with valuable spices. The sight captivated the second disciple.
Concentration and focus that enabled him
to procure the Nilambari flowers. All the disciples eventually returned to Buddha.
सोचना होगा करने से होगा, बस सोचने से कुछ ना होगा करने से होगा, खुद खुद के जीने से ना होगा करने से होगा, करने से होगा।
Students find difficulty in the cultivation of undivided concentration and cessation of these distractions. Students find themselves drawn towards the allure of social media and video games.
As students are unwavering focus must be fixed on our tasks and objectives when attending classes and enhancing our skills, our minds should be solely dedicated to pursuit of knowledge. Our commitment to our goals should remain undeterred by external influences. The art of living concept is to develop right focus and concentration to overcome fear, temptations, and obstacles.
For their unmatched valor, awareness, and alertness. The National Bravery Award scheme was initiated by the ICCW to give due recognition to the children who distinguish themselves by performing outstanding deeds of bravery and meritorious service and to inspire other children to emulate their example. The award is presented by the Prime Minister on the eve of Republic Day. Prior to this, the President hosts a reception for them.
On the eve of Republic Day 2015, 24 children selected for National Narendra Modi. 8-year-old Monmani Ijum became the youngest recipient of this award for showing an exemplary courage and using presence of mind in rescuing her drowning grandmother from a river at Churi village in Vokha district of Nagaland. An evening before, the president, Mr. Pranab Mukherjee, hosted a reception in honor of the children.
भारत में राष्ट्रीय वीरता पुरस्कार भारतीय बाल कल्याण परिषद द्वारा वीर बच्चों को दिए जाने वाले पुरस्कारों का एक समूह है। ऐसी ही वीरता की मिसाल आज हमारे बीच मौजूद है नागालैंड से 8 वर्षीय मॉनवेनी इंजुम। ये इस वर्ष राष्ट्रीय वीरता पुरस्कार पाने वाली सबसे कम उम्र की विजेता है। इन्होंने अपनी वीरता का प्रमाण देते हुए अपनी नानी को नागालैंड के चुड़ी गांव में एक नदी में डूबने से अकेले बचा कर दिया है।
Congratulations, my dear child. We are really proud of you. The alertness that you have shown at such a young age is commendable. You have proven that a good watch prevents misfortune. What made you take this quick decision of running all alone back to the village?
Thank you, sir, for your kind words. My grandma has always taught me that courage is not the absence of fear, but the triumph over it. It was my love for my grandma that helped me conquer my fear and cover the entire stretch alone. Saving her was the only concern that acted as a driving force for me.
Her words left everyone spellbound. Everyone attending the ceremony was captivated by the response and the spark in her eyes. Let us take you all to the flashback to the day when Monbeni was getting ready for the most exciting time of the year. Time to visit her grandma during her vacation.
It was the last day of the school before the winter vacation. Monmani and her friends were on their way back home. They were discussing about their plans and the places they are going to visit in the winter break.
Hey, do you know, my father is back from Kolkata and we will be going to Tawang. It is a beautiful place.
Yes, I have been there last year. This year, my grandma will take me to our town. We have a big house there.
My nanny ma is also eagerly waiting for us. I am so excited to meet her.
You know, she's the one who helped me to learn fishing.
Fishing? Wow!
Yes, she loves me very much. She always keeps laddus for me, feeds me with her own hands, tells me stories and sings lullabies to me whenever I visit her.
Monmani, give our regards to your nanny and please bring some laddus for us also when you come back.
Oh yes, why not? Oh, I'm getting late. Mama must be waiting for me.
Bye. We will meet after vacation with lots of stories.
Hello, I am back.
Oh my child, how I have been waiting for you. Quickly go and freshen up. We got to go.
Oh yes, I'm so excited. Have you kept the sari that we have got for Nani?
Yes, dear. Come on, now we need to board the bus in an hour. Keep your books and notebooks carefully.
Okay,
grandmother place in Shuddi village in Bokha district of Nagaland, a village with its quaint little houses surrounded by forest and rice fields offers an opportunity to experience the peace, quiet and calm of Naga village amidst the greenery and fresh air. The place is perfect for bird and butterfly watching nature walks. Grandmother Rethunlo Jungi, then 78, lived here alone in her house. She used to work on a handloom machine to earn a living.
Azutsa, Azutsa, where are you? We have come.
Oh my dear Mon Mini, how I missed you. You have grown so tall. My baby is grown up now.
Yes, Azutsa. I am 8 years old now. I am a big girl now. It is all the magic of your special sweet laddus. My friends were also asking for them. Will you please make for them too?
Ah, sure, my child. Come, let me make something for you. You must be hungry.
There is no other love that's as special as the love of a grandma. So warm and fuzzy, so calm and sweet, so cheerful and joyful. A wonderful combination of warmth, kindness, laughter and love. The time they both spent together will make every one of you reminiscent your childhood and recollect the enjoyable memories. How thankful you are for your grandparents. Don't we all cherish the time when we are with our parents and grandparents? Long walks, story times, dancing, singing lullabies.
Montmelly and her grandma also had this fun time along with the other children in the neighborhood. I am certain, when we listen to the old clock, Nani Teri Moni, our hearts flutter with love for our grandparents. And which choir presents its own voice.
ready to go to work. Here, Mon Mani and Grandma were collecting the things to be taken along.
Azout Sama, have you kept the fishing net? You promised me that you will take me for fishing.
Oh, okay dear, I'll keep it. Wear the boots and also keep your raincoat. It may rain today. Now let's move. Otherwise, we will be late for the fair.
Mon Mani and Grandma enjoyed at various stalls. Mon Mani got specially attracted by the dance performances.
Ladies and gentlemen, and my dear friend, we present to you the song sung at one of the award functions to celebrate the prudence of little brave heart of our country.
Hey, Parmeshwar,
Hey, Pratham,
Nitya Tumhare Charno Mein
we are on the mission of acquiring knowledge. So, we should always be conscious of what we feed our body and mind. Healthy food is needed to keep our body fit. Right food and positive and concentrated thoughts help the mind to stay focused. Each one of us is facing information overload and junk content that disrupts our minds. What we feed to our mind and body decides what we achieve. Healthy food is needed to keep our body fit.
Mahatma Gandhi's three wise monkeys represent principle see no evil, hear no evil, speak no evil. By covering their eyes, mouth and ears, he is also giving message that we should filter right things from our atmosphere or we should give right a heart to our senses.
Welcome you to our program. First of all, I would like to congratulate you on receiving the prestigious Santopa Humanitarian Award for your contribution to the society. You have come a long way. What fueled your vision?
I'm honored, ma'am. My unwavering passion for education, combined with the pressing need for socio-economic upliftment of the Ladakhi community, has not only ignited my drive, but has also served as my guiding compass. It is this fervor that propels me forward, giving both purpose and direction to my efforts. So, in the year 1998, with a few like-minded people, I started a new initiative called SECMOON, that is Students Educational and Cultural Movement of Ladakh. Let me take you to SECMOON. SECMOON is an eco-village where students, staff and volunteers live, work and learn together. It is not a conventional school, but a place to pursue practical, environmental, socio and traditional knowledge, values and skills.
Sir, how do you manage your campus?
Our campus is maintained and to a large degree run by the students themselves on a democratic basis. Elections are held every 2 months and the winning team manages all the operations at the campus for the next 2 months. They perform kitchen duties, do construction work, gardening, take care of the cows, manage solar panels and all the useful waste materials. You will be amazed to see them performing all these activities. Let me take you to a new project's construction site.
To enriching the education community, continuing striving to enhance its practical effectiveness in the real world. The construction activities at our campus embody the principle of hands-on learning. Students actively participate in building and maintaining the campus infrastructure, gaining practical skills that are essential for real-world applications. This approach not only empowers students, but also reinforces the idea that education should be practical and experiential. Here, all the construction work also is done by the students. We are constructing a new eco-friendly dormitory. We make sure it is well insulated to handle Ladakh's extreme temperature.
I have brought some stones from the nearby quarry for the foundation. I am making the mortar ready. Can you please check its consistency? Is it okay or needs more water to be added? Yes, it seems to be perfect.
Can you give me a hand with lifting these bricks? Thank you, dear. Teamwork makes the dream work. It's incredible to see our project taking shape. We are making a lasting impact here.
Yes, and we are learning valuable skills by contributing to a sustainable future.
We should collect all the construction waste for recycling.
Let's make sure the site is clean and safe before we call it a day. We never forget to wear our safety gears. Safety is our first priority on the construction site. We always follow the collaborative and environmentally conscious approach while engaging in construction work at the campus.
Oh, I see. The kitchen site is quite busy.
Indeed, performing kitchen duties is an important part of the daily routine. Students take turns preparing meals, cleaning up, and managing the kitchen facilities. This not only teaches them valuable cooking and hygiene skills, but also promotes teamwork and a sense of community
within the campus. Let's see what is being prepared by our young learners today.
What are you cooking for lunch today?
These are fresh vegetables from our garden. I am making a delicious salad.
We are cooking sambar, yeshi, and your favorite soup. Hope you are going to enjoy this all. I think soup lacks something. Should I add more spices to it?
Let me taste it. It needs a little more salt and pepper. This meal has turned out delicious. How fresh ingredients make a difference.
Oops, I have burned the onions.
No worries, we can always start over. Cooking is all about learning from our mistakes. Let me help you with these dishes.
Let me add these peels to the compost pit.
Isn't it so satisfying to eat the food we have grown and prepared ourselves? It's nutritious and healthy. We learn to grow our own vegetables in school's organic gardens and utilize these fresh ingredients in our daily cooking, fostering a deep connection to the environment and the importance of sustainable living.
That's indeed very impressive.
Breathtaking embrace, I found my calling, a passion that fuels my unwavering pursuit. It's more than just waste management. It's about cherishing the soul of this remarkable place. Ladakh's natural beauty and its ecological significance are what inspire me every day. Through proper waste management, I aim to protect this environment, to prevent pollution and to preserve the very essence of Ladakh's unique ecosystems. Let me take you to waste management site.
Learning to manage waste is an integral part of our sustainable living practices. Alright, it's time to manage the waste. Let's collect recyclables, compost, and non-recyclables. I will take care of collecting plastic bottles and paper for recycling. And I will gather glass containers and any metal items we can recycle. We don't throw disposables here. See these plastic bottles, wooden and cardboard pieces. We store them at one place and the students who need them can take from there for their innovative ventures. Look at these beautiful planters and these home decors that we have made from waste plastic and glass bottles. We follow the proactive and community-oriented approach while managing waste at our campus, emphasizing recycling, composting, and reducing waste generation.
I must say that your students have become passionate towards environment. Let me show you a glimpse of how gardening is performed at our campus. Essentially, I see gardening activities as a means to teach lifelong lessons about patience, nurturing, and the cycles of life driven by my passion for connecting people with their profound wisdom of nature. These experiences not only contribute to a well-rounded education but also instill values of mindfulness and appreciation for the natural world.
Let's discuss what crop we should plant in our garden this season. But either way, the altitude and climate, we should focus on cold, resistant vegetables. I have bought some local seeds for radish and spinach. Will this work?
Perfect! Native varieties are
dead for this environment.
Before planting, we should add compost to enrich the soil. It will provide essential nutrients and improve water retention.
The weeds are starting to sprout. We should remove the weeds.
Yes, keeping the garden weed free will help our crops thrive.
I have noticed some aphids on these plants. What should we do?
We can try neem oil spray. It's a natural pesticide.
See these jam waters. Every year we camp out at Alchi Gompa for 2 days and make several hundred jars of apricot jam. We not only consume it but sell it also.
The tomatoes look ripe. Should we start harvesting?
Yes, they are red and plump.
We can gather them.
We have more tomatoes than we can eat.
Let's share with the local community.
It's a great way to build connections and support each other.
Don't forget to save some seeds from our best plants for next year.
Right, it's essential for sustainability and self-sufficiency.
Through hands-on learning, we are able to make a noticeable improvement in the students' performance. Hands-on learning is of paramount importance for students, as it contributes a lot to the students' holistic development and educational success. This dynamic and effective educational approach has enriched students' academic experiences as well as enhanced their cognitive and practical skills. It has helped prepare them for lifelong learning and success in various aspects of life. My unwavering passion and relentless pursuit that paved the path for me to achieve meticulously crafted, predetermined aims. I dedicated my efforts not only to the realm of education, but also to the empowerment and betterment of Ladakhi community. Due to global warming, Himalayan glaciers are melting. This led to scarcity of water in Ladakh. To solve this problem of water supply, my team worked on an innovation. We came up with a new method to freeze water during winters when it is in abundance, and then use this surplus water during spring months, April and May, as it melts, providing water to the farmers.
Let us show you how ice stupa works. A pipe is connected from a high level source of water to low level. That is the stupa site, where the structure will collect the water. At such low temperature, water can freeze in these pipes itself. Therefore, the entire pipeline is kept 4 feet below the ground. As it always maintains its level, and so it will keep the same water at its source. Thanks, gravity. When this water comes in the contact of the low temperature, it instantly freezes.
A self-built structure. Its geometrical shape makes the ice melt slower.
This ice stupa lasts till late May when farmers need water the most.
The first ice stupa that we created had a height of 64 feet, which was higher than the ice stupa listed in the Guinness Book of World Records. With an aim to promote artificial nature and save water for irrigation, ice stupa competition is being held in 2019.
In 2019, 12 ice stupas, and in 2020, around 25 ice stupas were built.
The ice stupa project is indeed a remarkable initiative by Sonam Mangchu. It's inspired innovative ideas addressing water scarcity in the region. Sonam sir, I request you to address and encourage our young learners.
Dear students, I stand before you today not just as an educator but as someone who believes in your incredible potential. Each one of you has a unique set of talents, dreams and aspirations, and it's my utmost desire to see you accomplish the extraordinary in life with a heart filled with unwavering passion and a relentless pursuit of excellence. I embarked on a journey that helped me attain my goals. I implore you all to achieve the triumphant trifecta of bright head, loving heart and skilled hands, hallmark of a student.
Life often presents challenges and obstacles, but it's in overcoming these challenges that we find our true strength. Greatness doesn't come from playing it safe. It comes from pushing boundaries, taking risks and stepping out of our comfort zones. Embrace failure as a stepping stone to success, for it's in those moments of setback that we learn the most. We should find our right passion, the one that sets our soul on fire, and let it be the compass guiding our pursuits. In the olden days, disciples used to sacrifice the comfort of their homes and go to Gurukul to receive education and discover their passion. In current times, the art of living concept teaches students to come out of their comfort zones to pursue one's passion. It is only our dedication towards our passion that distinguishes a champion from the crowd. What an enlightening journey into the truth that transforms. Thank you all for the experience sublime.